Good morning. Good morning, my EVL Winter Battle Royale audience. I'm being told that we're still waiting for some players to join the server, and please be patient as these people are trying to get this organized and get this set up. So, thanks for tuning in. I'm going to play some more tunes, and we'll be airing shortly. Thanks. A cold night getting warmer now. The ground shakes as I love this loud. We are the champions, the champions of the night. We are the champions, the champions of the night. Yeah. Alright, I was being told that it was hard to hear my voice over the music, so I'm turning the music a little bit lower. Good morning, everybody. Thanks for tuning into the stream. We are having a little bit of trouble getting one of the teams organized and some players. I guess they're having some trouble connecting, so we're trying to figure that out right now. Stream's going to start really soon. I appreciate your patience. Just going to stream a little music for a little while, and I may bring in the casters a little bit too. We may talk about the stream and the event, and hope to have a lot of fun today. So again, thanks for tuning in, and here's some more music.
Hello, everybody, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the EVL Winter Battle Royale 2015 edition. I'm one of your casters, Flatland, and I'm going to be joined with my partner, Zoe, here for some 4v4 video game action extraordinaire. And my phone just started ringing. That's perfect timing. We're excited to bring you this first matchup on Koth Railbridge. We're going to start getting into the action as soon as possible. We're just waiting for some people to get in the server. And my phone stopped ringing, so I'm not even going to care. yeah, the caster's curse. But, yep, we're going to wait for the server to go live right now. Of course, we got some awesome prizes and some awesome events coming up today, like the EVL Winter Battle Royale Melee, where you can win up to an Intel i5 processor, which is crazy, especially for such a small event like this. And of course, the winners of this tournament are going to pick up a nice SSD for their video gaming pleasure. I think it's 128 gigs, which is pretty huge, especially for an SSD. But we do have one team in the server right now, and we're just waiting for Team Diglett, I believe, to join up.
Well, in case you didn't hear it, that is Flatline, my casting partner. I'm Zoe, and we both have some competitive TF2 background on us. Definitely going to be a new, interesting format with this 4v4, especially in Koth Railbridge. This map, not usually a map you see very often, but it's still a great, fun map. Flatline himself is a UTC plat spy, currently backing up on Neon's team. Yeah. I am playing as a gold sniper on Dodorus this season.
Back in gold, gamer. Anyways, this is a pretty good map. I think it won star. I think we got second place in Stars Mapping Contest way back in 2012. And I think the winner of that was Koth Arctic, so we're gonna probably see some quality map here.
Arctic is my favorite map of all time, so
this
got second place. Looks like we're pretty good.
Looks like we are starting to get some people from Team Diglett joining up, so hopefully we can go live soon.
That is the hope, as starting a little bit after expected, but you know what? It's just a little bit of delay. Nothing hurt. So, currently just waiting for the other team to get in here. Do you want to go over anything about this map in particular and talk about what made this map the second place map?
I don't actually have a lot of history with this map, but I know just from looking at it, it's definitely got a very height-based dynamic. As you can see, there's a huge bridge right across the middle point. So there's definitely going to be a huge fight with all these entrances to get up there for people trying to control it, especially when you hold on to the point, because it's going to be pretty hard to cap if you've got like four people spamming down on you. It's definitely a very height-based map. I don't think the skybox is very, very short. I think it's like way up in the sky, so obviously we're going to see a lot of aerial battles. I don't know about the 4v4 whitelist, maybe even the base jumper is allowed. That would be pretty dumb, but I don't know the UGC4's whitelist. To be honest, I am not a huge fan of 4s. I've played it once, and I'm not sure, too used to the dynamic around it. I know it's definitely smaller, so there's a lot less crazy stuff going on, and you can get a lot more coordinated plays off. But hopefully we can see some pretty good TF2 action here today, gamers. We do have 5 out of 8 people on the server right now, so hopefully we can go live soon.
Sorry about that. My mumble froze for a little bit there, and I was trying to respond, but you said that. Do I expect some good TF2 action here tonight?
I did.
I'm expecting some great TF2 action, actually, because both these teams, these guys look like they're going to be pretty good. I'm not too familiar with 4v4, as I've only played it for one season in UGC and didn't play that much. But what I do know is that this is a very fun game mode. These teams are obviously ready to play 4v4. And it's going to be pretty great watching these guys go head-to-head. Lunam, if you take a look at him right now on the red team, he actually has a Australian frying pan. Which,
yep.
I mean, he could buy the tournament with that thing. That is a very nice item indeed. So keep an eye out for Lunemp. I want to see how many gold pan kills he can get in this tournament. And who knows, maybe we'll have I'll count a little tracker. And if he gets 5 golden pan kills, then maybe I'll do something for everybody.
Should buy me all Australian sniper rifles.
Maybe.
Alright, so we are going to get the players in soon here. One person that I do notice right off the bat is Crab underscore F. I've seen him around on lobbies and on TF2 Mix before it sadly died. But he was pretty good. He was really good at Soldier, and he's running the direct hit right now. I don't know how proficient he is with it, but on a map like this, we're going to start seeing a lot of air shots.
Air shots are definitely going to be the big thing on this map. This map, I don't think he pointed out, this is a very Badlands-esque map. This is... It looks like Badlands, especially you look at the little bats right here that are facing the bridge. Those look like the Badland windows. Maybe you can jump through that. I haven't tried that out yet, but this is definitely a Badland feel, but definitely not Badlands. It's a lot different, but you can get that vibe.
Yeah, we are actually playing Badlands in this tournament. I think it's on the finals map off Badland Legend. It is the top final. The grand final, I think the teams can just pick whatever the map they want.
Yeah, Badland is obviously, that is the staple map of, in my opinion, of all TF2.
Definitely.
Obviously you don't play an Highlander, but it is going to be the Big Sixes one, so... I think that this is a little nice thing, because this is the first map of the, this is the first map of the day. And the final map of the entire tournament is... It's gonna be... Badlands, so we're starting from... Feels like Badlands 2, actually Badlands.
And we're gonna go to Feels Like Lakeside after this with Koth Sandstone. Another little new map. I saw it on TFTV with its dev, and he looks really committed to making it a stable map in Highlander. We're actually gonna be playing a relatively old version, B8D. I think it's in B18 right now. But I went over it before we started casting, and it looks really cool. It's definitely very Egyptian-inspired, Lakeside-inspired, even a bit of Egypt-inspired. It's not obviously not a CP map, but it still looks really cool, and it's got a lot of height-based elements, too, like this map.
So, do you want to talk about anything going on in other leagues, maybe UGC or something, while we're waiting for the rest of the players to pile in here?
Yep. Obviously, we do have 6 out of 8 in the server right now, so hopefully we can get going soon, but ESCA has just started their Season 18 sixes. I think we're in Week 3 right now. It's getting pretty heated, especially in Invite. Froyotech is obviously the team on top, but we've got a lot more contenders for LAN, and hopefully we can get some good sixes action out of that.
Of course.
And UGC has just started up their Season 14 Highlander and their Season 17 6v6, I believe, and their Season 4 4v4.
Cool.
All at the same time. And their Dota League, they've got a lot of things going on.
Looking at it, we have all 8 players in the server, and Crab underscore F is saying, ready? Question mark. So we could be getting going pretty soon here. Right. And what will be a pretty good 4v4 game.
Yeah, I think we can go over the rosters now that we have all 8 in the server.
Of course.
Looks like on red team we have Crab underscore F Weekend with the Soldier. We have Shex Z on Scout, Lunam on Demo, and Mills on Medic. And on the blue side we've got Chronic Discord on Demo, Knights on Scout, Shut Up Walter on Medic, and Beats on Soldier.
If you're not familiar with the 4v4 format, what happens is you only can have, obviously it's 4 players on each team, and you can only have one of each class, and there are a few rules and stipulations. For example, you can't have a heavy and medic at the same time. So if, for example, Mills on the red team wanted to go play heavy, or wanted a heavy, he would have to switch to heavy, or you'd have to switch off to a different class, while somebody else goes heavy.
I think we are live
and
here.
And we are live! There we go.
And all that chatting.
All the first match right here, and looking at it right now, we have Beats going down, and big danger coming for the blue medic. He goes down to a nice bazooka from Crab F Weekend. Red team's gonna take this early cap.
Yep, Crab already choosing to run that Beggar's Bazooka. Of course, it's whitelisted in fours, definitely a more lenient whitelist. And we could see Blue was already trying to take height advantage up there. They had the combo up on top, but they just got flanked from all sides.
Blue team also has a Pyro that's not one of the standard classes. Generally, you go with a Scout, Soldier, Demo, and Medic, but I don't think Knight C wants to follow the meta. And hopefully he can do a lot with that Pyro, as he's pulling off the point right now. Finally goes down after some nice fighting, and the Blue Medic is, look at him, he's on top of the rail bridge all alone, just kind of firing crossbows at Red. What is he doing?
Looks like he's trying to reconnect with his demo. But he is going to get out. Knights was on the back burner, and he was behind them on point, but he triggered the cap when he fell down. If he didn't get that cap triggered, he probably would have been able to get a lot of kills with that back burner. But we do see Beats up top all alone. Crab's going to take him down. Walter, his med's just a bit slow behind.
Ah, the demo goes down to the train!
Oh my gosh, yes, the train. We forgot to mention the train. Yep, there's a reason it's called a rail bridge, because there are trains literally everywhere. It looks like Red's about to... Looks like, yeah, Red has their Uber, but they don't really have the numbers.
Train disaster of 2015. We have Blue trying to cap the point, although looks like Shex doesn't want this to happen, but Blue's going to take this cap. But Red does have a significant Uber advantage, and they should be using this to get back on that point as soon as possible. And we're seeing a lot of work out here so far by Crab underscore F with that bazooka.
Yeah, definitely a bit weirder of an item, but if you know how to use it, you can definitely make people scared of it, especially with players like Sneaky Polar Bear. I remember him running it in like season 10 UGC plat, and he just destroyed everyone.
Shex another pick, and Shex gets the fish kill on the demo on Chronic Discord right there. Red's gonna recap this point, I believe, as they have Uber, and Blue only has 90%. As Medic's in danger right now, he's might go down. He's got 25 HP. Goes down. Shex gets the med pick.
He had 75% there. Well, 74, and he got a saw off someone while they were fighting him, but he just couldn't manage to get that one last percent, and that's gotta be really, it's gotta be really discouraging.
Little level 1 sentry gun up right now. Knights on the engineer does go down, not before they get the demo Lunam, so if I were Blue team, Medic is out all alone again. Like, this is a constant thing I'm seeing at the beginning. Walter is all alone at these fights. And he's gonna get a, he might, is he, yeah, he's not gonna get away from it. Crab F and Shex getting in there and cleaning up Knights and Walter. So if I were Blue team right now, I would definitely stop sending Walter out and start getting that Uber charge built. Red has a pop there.
We do see Knights back on the Pyro. Chronic does manage to take down Shex, but he's gonna trade with that lock and load. Of course, just so much self damage from all from the lock right now. They are coming out, but they don't have Uber, and this Crab's gonna be able to.
Red pops their Uber. Finally, they've had that for a long time, and there goes the Blue Medica almost full wipe as Chronic just spawned. This isn't looking good for this Blue team.
Yeah, and I think that Team Diglett has some pretty basic things they need to remedy before they can challenge this. Obviously, their med getting picked out a lot, and like being the first one in is one of them. And if they can fix some of that stuff, they're definitely gonna have a better time in the second round.
Of course. So looks like Blue's getting some cap time. Looks like some Knights back on Spy. He's been changing his class pretty much every single life. Oh, here we go. We have a mid fight right now. Beats trying to do something. Can't. And that's the first round going to team Lunam right now. And Crab underscore F, 2 dominations, 20 points. Absolutely proving his... He's carrying his weight right now.
I didn't think I picked out a good player to watch here. Knight's gonna switch to Soldier for this mid. He's actually pulling out the bazooka himself. And we have the mid fight up top. Crab F is getting in really far right now, and he's gonna be able to get the 2k with the Beggar's bazooka. He had his scouts in just picking getting some damage on that.
Gets an assist right there. Knight's with Luna picking up the kill, and looks like a full wipe right now for the Blue team. Blue team, I think, honestly just needs to maybe build up an Uber charge and go and challenge this Red team, because Red had only popped their Uber once in that last round. And that's not something you need to do, especially if you're losing a Medic and Demo go down again. Shex and Crab F getting those kills. I don't know, this is just a little too aggressive, and red team's now pushed up into the spawn. We have the demo camping the doors, and Crab F gets the medic and another 5k.
And the demo. Crab's just going huge right now.
He is dominating every player on their team.
This is crazy. I mean, you kind of expect to see some roles from the first round, but this is kind of crazy.
Yeah, this is a bit of this is a bit much. I'm a little glad to see that the team is. I hope they're backing up. Yeah, it looks like they're backing up, except for the demo. It's a nice little show of sportsmanship. I was about to say that I don't like how Red is pushing into their spawn and making it just kind of bullying them at spawn. That's a little too much.
Walter's actually on Pyro right now. He does manage to get a kill, and they do have a numbers advantage, but it's the combo that's up for Red, and they're just really carrying this team right now.
And Blue doesn't have a medic anymore, so even if the Red team's now backing up, they can't build an Uber charge. And nope, here we go. This is the one stipulation. We have Knights now on Heavy to fill up that missing medic spot. Here we go, Red Uber pop. They finally get that pop. Walter forcing a Crab F on an 8k right now. This is pretty insane.
I was looking at the first round logs, and Crab F is doing 840 DPM with that beggars. Just going crazy huge right now.
That's insane numbers. 840 DPM?
Yeah.
Wow.
Knights to Heavy getting stuck out in the staircase there. Not really much you can do. I don't think Heavy is a really good choice on this map. It's just too wide and spread out, and it takes you a really long time to get anywhere.
Yeah, if I were the blue team, I'd have the medic come back here. Knights back on medic, they need to build this Uber charge. This is kind of killing this blue team right now that they haven't built an Uber charge, and the medic, instead of building Uber charge, is going to go out and fight with syringes. Maybe this is the strat. Just, you know what? Instead of following the normal meta, we're going to go out there, we're going to have a lot of fun. But I don't know how much you're going to have when you're letting a Beggar's Bazooka Soldier do 840 DPM and go on an 11k.
Yeah, there's not much to do. It looks like they're just getting out DM'd right now. Knight's finally going to be able to hook up with someone and get some heals out, but they only have 12 seconds left, and they're going to have to push off Uber here. They actually do have even numbers, but again, it's the combo for Red that's up, and they're just healing. They're just playing so well together.
The advantage, though, is that Uber charge popped on Red. Nice shot by Crab F, and this is looking pretty bleak right now, and even though Crab's getting launched and finally goes down, do we have a chance? Blue team's going to be able to get this point, I think. All three of their members are on point, although hurt, and the Red demo is not being able to clean up any of them.
And Soldier goes for the bomb and misses. Finally, and Scout's in behind, though, and it's just Chronic alive, and he's got to hit some choice pipes right now with 5 health. He's going to go down to the chip from the Scout, and it's just Knights alive, and that looks like it's going to be round 2.
Yeah, it looks like the round is going to go to the team Lunan again. They are up 2-0. I don't know, this is kind of a weird showing coming from Team Blue. Now they don't even have a Heavy or a Medic, they have an Engineer. I guess it's building and spawn going for level 3. I'm kind of curious to see what Knights can do with that level 3 Sentry Gun. I'm unsure what the strategy is here for Red. Maybe they know that they're just kind of being beaten down, and they're just like, you know what, we're not gonna let this bring us down. We're gonna have some fun with this, because as it's showing, Team Red is thrashing Team Blue right now.
I thought Knights was gonna bring it up to the bridge, because with the range of the center, you can really do a lot on that bridge. But he's just putting it in spawn, or actually, he's going to rebuild it outside the door and then carry it again. Looks like he is going up top though, and looks like they're all traveling with him. And if they can manage to get the sentry up here and actually defend it well, they should be able to get a lot of point presence.
Knights is pretty hurt, though. He just picked up a health pack, and it's only him and Beats up, so... Who up for both teams is...
Crab getting on the sentry, but he's only 60 health, and he is going to back out, so the sentry already doing a job of denying. Knights is still up to attend to it, too. So if they can just keep moving this up a little bit more, they're going to be able to take some definite point time. But they need to, like, protect Knights like a med.
He's going to be in the window watching over the point as he's got a scout on the sentry gun. Save that gun! He... manages to keep the gun up, and here we go. It's doing work. Takes one pick. Unam off the bat. Scout trying to chip it down. Yeah, he's trying to chip his sentry gun down. I am the blue team. I'd be defending the sentry gun with my life. That is the most valuable asset right now. And red Uber was forced there by Beats. Nice job by Beats forcing that Uber with the sentry gun behind him. And he's going to go straight for the cap. This is the thing the blue team needs. A quick cap with enough time in the map where they can recap it. But as I say that, Crab goes on a 7k. And man, Crab has been on the most insane killstreaks. Nice reflect out there. Okay.
And the sentry's still up, and it looks like they're going to be able to take the point with that sentry. It's just doing so much, and they can't get it in the window. All these rockets are getting blocked. Nice positioning there by Knights.
Sentry gun is hurt, though. Denji's trying to get back. He gets it up. That sentry gun. I was a little curious to see what Knights was doing at the beginning of the round, but looks like it's definitely paying off right now. No medic, no problem. But it is a bit of a problem. Look at Blue Team's health. They lost their demo, and it was basically demo or soldier gets health back, one of them dies, so not having a medic really hurts, but Red Uber is forced here, but forced a little early, so they can't pop on the gun directly, but they get it. Nice job by Crab F.
And that's going to be pretty much the end of that round for now, at least. They're going to be able to get this point back, and they're going to have a decent amount of time. Looks like Blue's going to be able to bring it down to like 205 at most. But I think they had something going there, Blue Team did. If they got Walter to go up on med, they would have been able to hold that a lot longer and a lot better.
Maybe so. Crabath now on a 12k, out of that. He's on a 12k right now with Bazooka and four Doms again. I don't think this guy can be stopped this match. If I were the Blue Team, I would probably try to have... I was about to say, have a sniper deal with him. Knight's going on sniper, but... gets bazooka'd out immediately by Crab F. I don't think Blue Team could do anything right now. This round is looking lost with Crab F just being absolutely a monster on that Beggar's Bazooka Soldier. And thank God that thing is banned in the competitive Highlander, because now you're seeing the true power of that weapon.
And Lunum gets his first pan kill on Chronic Discord with 3 health. It's like just getting fun.
The first pan kill, that's all we came here, folks. That's a joke. We
the
came
golden
here for a lot
demo.
More.
Beats already calling GG, and at this point it seems like a forlorn conclusion. This looks like a steel team versus an invite team, to be honest here.
I wouldn't say that. I just say that it's just that blue team, they just don't look coordinated right now. They don't look like they're working together. They're running weird classes. Well, red team has an off-class once. And we'll take that third round. Crab F, 71-point, 16-kill streak.
He is currently doing 790 PM going 40-2 with a 24 KD.
That's pretty insane.
That is really unbelievable.
If we're going to talk player of the game, we're going with Crab F, and there's one more round, but the blue team is, they call GGs. Do they want to keep doing this one more round, or are they just gonna hang their heads low? I mean, if I were that blue team, I'd just kind of do a fourth round for fun, try to see if they could maybe even injure this red team, see if they have a weakness. Because looking at it, this red team looks pretty good. My only problem with them is that, Lunam needs to do a little bit more for them. He's got 25 points. I need to pull up the logs right now, but he's obviously doing a little bit worse than everybody else. But that may be just because you're playing with Crab_F, who's absolutely just, he's a monster. So maybe that's the case, but I want to see some more work out of Lunam in the second half. Out of this one round, or maybe more if Blue can get their stuff together. And, I don't know.
Looks like we are going to go live here for the fourth round.
This is the second half right now. We have Team Lunam up 3-0 after pretty deciding 3 rounds. We have Beats on Sniper and Walter on Pyro, Chronic Discord Demo, and Knights on Medic.
and Knights is on the crits key right now. And if they get this crits lockout, it's going to be carnage at its purest form. Knights are already taking some early damage, though, and they're just getting locked out of up top by that
One thing I'm noticing right now is that the Uber is building faster than the crits, which, if you know anything about this game, if you don't, the crits key is a weapon that charges your weapon with invulnerability, well, not with invulnerability, with the critical hits. So when you use the crits krieg, it makes your weapon flash blue or red, and you do a lot more damage. While the ubercharge, the gun that the red medic is using, it makes you invulnerable. Invulnerable for 8 seconds of damage. So the point of using the crits is that it built a little faster than the uber, but that red medic built that uber a lot faster than the crits, which is pretty surprising.
Yeah, I don't know, especially because the red medic was like crossbowing off cliff for a couple of seconds there, and he still managed to have an uber advantage. So I don't know if Knights just wasn't healing that whole mid or whatever, but looks like he's gonna come back up, and he's still on the crits. Red has their full uber, so they need to get a force off right now.
Yeah.
You know, the one thing I haven't seen is like a sack wave come out. I mean, in fours, you obviously don't have enough as many people to sack, but I think you could kind of like just get away with sacking in two people, like a demo or a soldier.
Yeah, it's I would say to Beats go for those sack plays, because that red medic has only popped his uber very few times this game, which, if you know anything about competitive TF2, the medics usually don't hold uber for this long. They usually pop to save their teammates or save point, but that red medic not getting a lot of pressure. But he is getting pressure now, forced to use. Nice play rate coming in from Chronic at Beats. And Chronic saying something in game. Saying something in game as a nice force, and now Knights is a bit of an advantage to work off of. I think that this blue team needs to park the bus and just get this. Are they still on crits?
I believe so. Yes, they are.
So they need to just park the bus and get this crits advantage going. Now knowing that Red has popped their Uber, instead of trying to fight the medic. Soldiers bombing in. Yeah, oh sorry, Demo bombed in, just picked up two in himself. And we have a 2v2. Shex winning that battle with 5 HP against Chronic Discord, and it's looking pretty bleak right now for this blue team.
We do have Beats on Scout now, let's see if he can do anything. He does pick up a kill on Shex, and they're going to be able to try and get some point time. I don't know where the combo for Red is. They're actually just coming out of spawn right now with an 85% uber.
Yeah, they lost a lot of numbers, but they lost Crabeth and Lunim on there, just Shex and Mill surviving that engagement, but the important part is that Mill survived it, and now he's got full uber. Blue caps the point here, which is, and this is a nice sight for Sorry Eyes, but Red's gonna immediately recap it with only Beats up, and a scout can't fight off a team of four, so.
We do have Knights coming up on Spy. Beat's gonna go down in that fight, and they're gonna be able to recap it. Blue got about 17 seconds up on it, but you're gonna need a little bit more to win this match.
Yeah. Chronic said their freaking bazooka has always been BS, but Jesus, when played against a decent soldier, that is brutal. That has been brutal. Crabeth has
certainly
easily been the player of the game. And looking at it right now, it looks like it's going to be a 20 seconds left. I don't see Blue coming back from this. They're only up one. Red just popped their Uber, but still have a little bit of an advantage. Looks like this is going to be it for the Blue team.
An interesting statistic. I looked in the last round, and Knights has played 8 out of the 9 classes in the game.
That might be a bit of an issue, having one player constantly playing every class instead of having...
Is it though? Is it GG?
Just consistency, really.
Yeah.
He played every class but Demo.
Yeah, Chronic saying, is it GG, as GGs are called. Team Lunam will win this battle for nothing and will continue on their journey to become the best team at this EVL Winter Battle Royale.
Looks like they're going to be going up against either Karate Spies or Luigi's Battalion. The game against... We're going to be casting Upward Momentum, the team that just won, versus either Karate Spies or Luigi's Battalion soon. As soon as they finish their game. It looks like we're going to have a producer restart the stream pretty quick. So we'll be right back. About 30 seconds max, guys. Don't freak out. Orel isn't ending.